If we want to talk about the most perfect wedding, the most Islamic wedding, it was the wedding of Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam and Fatima al-Zahra. The most beautiful wedding, the most successful wedding, the most simple wedding, and the wedding that brought the most, the happiest marriage, the happiest marriage, and the most successful marriage. Imam Ali alayhi salam came to propose to Fatima al-Zahra. First, Abu Bakr came and proposed, if you remember from my lecture. He was rejected. Umar came and proposed to Fatima al-Zahra. He was also denied. They came to him, they both, Abu Bakr and Umar, they came to Imam Ali alayhi salam. They told him, look, we proposed to Rasulullah for Fatima al-Zahra's hand in marriage and we were both denied. You go and propose. Amir al-Mu'mineen said, okay. He went. He knocked at the door of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. Rasulullah greeted him. He sat down and he put his head to the ground, very shy, very embarrassed, not able to say a word. You know, young men today when they go and propose, they're playing with their phones, you know, they're tweeting, they're taking selfies, they're joking around in front of their father-in-law. You know, no embarrassment, not being shy whatsoever. Have you heard of the story of the young man who went and proposed and he was chewing gum? Let me tell you this story. Salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad.
A young man goes and he proposes to a father and he was chewing gum. You know, in our culture, that's very disrespectful. You go and you're chewing gum in front of your future father-in-law. So the father-in-law, the man, the father of the lady, he told him, do you always chew gum in front of adults? He said, no. But you know, it's this nicotine gum. Told him, well, why are you chewing that kind of gum? He said, well, you know, I'm trying to quit smoking. He said, oh, so you smoke? He said, well, yeah, you know, when you're trying to quit taking drugs, you start smoking cigarettes. He told him, so you used to take drugs. He said, well, obviously, when you're in jail, you learn to take drugs. He said, you're in jail. He said, well, yeah, I mean, when you kill people, you go to jail. He told him, you killed someone? He said, yeah. He told him, who? He said, some father, I went, I proposed to his daughter, he refused, so I killed him. Imam Ali alayhi salam, he comes in the presence of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, his head is down, he doesn't say a word, he's embarrassed, he's shy, he couldn't even say that I'm here to propose. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, he began, he took the initiative. He told him, Ya Ali, perhaps you're here to propose to my daughter, Fatima. He said, indeed, Ya Rasulullah, indeed. Rasulullah got up and he came and he asked Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam. He said that Amir al-Mu'mineen, Ali ibn Abi Talib, your cousin, is here proposing to you. What do you say? Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam also, she put her head down, not saying a word. You know, not like young ladies today when a handsome guy comes and proposes. You hear the shouting from inside. You know, the extreme shouting and they're overjoyed. Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam put her head down. She didn't say a word. She didn't say a word. And Rasulullah here said his famous statement. He said, Subhanallah, sukutuha radaha. That her silence is a sign of her, what? Acceptance. And this became a general law, that if a young lady, she's proposed to and she remains silent, then it's a sign of her what? Acceptance. Because if she does not accept, she'll say something. But if she accepts, she's embarrassed in front of her father to say so, she remained quiet. Rasulullah realized that she accepted. Jibra'il comes down and he said, Ya Rasulullah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has recited their nikah up in the sky among the angels. Among the angels, the nikah of Ali ibn Abi Talib and Fatima al-Zahra has been recited. And Allah says, Zawwij an-nura min an-nur. Zawwij Ali min Fatima. Give the light to the light. Give Ali ibn Abi Talib to Fatima al-Zahra. Salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad.
They prepared for the wedding. They prepared for the marriage. Rasulullah asked Ali ibn Abi Talib, what do you own, Ya Ali? What do you own? What do you have? He said, Ya Rasulullah, I only own two things. Two things. My sword and my shield. These are the two things that I own. And I own a very small house. Amir al-Mu'mineen, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, as for your sword, then you can't sell it. Because we need your sword. Islam needs your sword. As for your shield, you don't need your shield, Ali ibn Abi Talib. Go and sell your shield. He went and he sold it. And with the price of the shield, he was able to furnish his house. Very simple furniture. He furnished the house. The night of the wedding, Fatima al-Zahra, the famous story. Fatima al-Zahra had a wedding dress prepared for her. The night of her wedding, a poor lady came and knocked at the door and asked for something. Fatima al-Zahra goes, she left everything, she came and she gave her the wedding dress. She gave her wedding dress. Rasulullah asked her, he told her, why did you give your wedding dress? She said, because the Quran says, لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحَبُّونَ, that you will not reach righteousness until you give that which you love. You know, there's people, they donate the things that they don't need. The old clothes, the whatever that's old, they give it to the poor. True righteousness is when you give the things that you need the most, the things that you like the most. She gave her wedding dress. On the day of the wedding, it was simple food. Simple food. It was one sheep with some dates and some milk. That was very good food back then. And it was enough for everyone. It was enough for everyone. There was no music. There was no DJ. There was no dancing. Instead, there was poetry recited. فاطمة خير نساء البشر ومن لها وجه كوجه القمر. That Fatima is the greatest lady from all of the women, and who has a face glowing like a moon, like the face of Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam. Beautiful wedding, beautiful people, beautiful bride, beautiful groom. And when they finally met, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took the hands of Ali ibn Abi Talib and the hand of Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam, and they put their hands together, and he told Fatima, Fatima, you're marrying the best of husbands. This is the best husband. Take care of your husband. And Ya Ali, you are marrying the best of wives. This is the best wife. Take care of my daughter, Ya Ali. I'm entrusting you with my daughter, Ya Ali. This was the best wedding in the Islamic history between the best husband and the best wife.